When I talk to students, the first thing I tell them, we are talking to you about the future technologies, where we are heading towards, but you will be building those technologies. So imagine your role 5 years or 10 years or 20 years from now, and that's where they get very much engaged.
I'm Santosh Kurinec. My research is on advanced nanoscale electronic materials and devices, and I'm
professor of electrical and microelectronic engineering department at Rochester Institute of Technology. The semiconductor technology is one of the most astounding technologies of the present generation. We have seen over the last decades this technology taking off, and we have seen such enormous computing power, communication power. And when students see that, they feel really excited about it. But to common public, I want to tell them, the moment you look at a cell phone or a very fast computer, there's this integrated circuit chip behind it. So how those chips are made, that's what we teach. So let's look at the smartphone. Almost everyone has this. So most people think it's some magic device. It gets information and you text your pictures and you get your information and messages. But what enables that? There are semiconductor chips inside, and that's what most people don't know. Microelectronic engineering is a discipline that teaches how those chips are built. So the semiconductor technology is expanding into new horizons, from computing to AI to healthcare to energy. So there will be demand for a lot more engineers in the future, and that's where we put all our passion in teaching young minds. I think we all have challenges in one form or the other. And women bring a unique perspective, and they are open to collaborations. And I think that if we have a mixed group of scientists and engineers, we share each other's experiences, and that helps us in solving problems. Science discovers, and engineering creates. So when we combine the two together, we can explore beyond what we have on planet Earth.